heart.
He has called us and set us apart.
This is what we have to do. What we have to do.
He sent me to
worship your holy name. Jesus, I will worship your holy name. Worship your holy name.
Good afternoon, brothers and sisters. This is Hour of Restoration. Today is January 23rd. And the January theme is hunger for righteousness. Welcome, everybody. Nancy, welcome. I want to start our restoration with a prayer. Julia, would you like to say prayer?
Sure. Thank you. Can I please join you in prayer? Our most beloved Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for this day, this opportunity to hear your message today to us. And Father, we're so grateful that we have so many different ways of receiving your message now with Zoom and in person. And we have no excuse not to be able to listen to your word and to take your word into our hearts and use it as food for our spirit and use it to do good in this world and to follow your will and do the things that you would have us to do. Heavenly Parent, we want to bring you into this time, into this holy hour that we're doing, the hour of restoration. We pray that you can be inspired by us and by our attentiveness and by our ability to absorb your message for us today from our brother Reverend Gabriel. I pray, Father, that we can really include you in all that we do in our entire lives. We know that you created us for this purpose, that you didn't create us to be aloof or to be standoffish or away from us, but you wanted to have an intimate and personal relationship with each and every one of us that is constantly growing within our own heart and mind. And I pray that that's what this hour of restoration can do, can help us to find that place where you live within us and bring it out and bring out the joy and the love and the concern that you have for each one of us. I pray all these things. And I ask your blessing on this hour in the name of your Son, our Lord, Jesus the Christ. Amen and adieu.
Amen. Thank you, Julia. So now we'd like to have one more song.
Bishop. Hi.
Bishop, welcome. Bishop.
Welcome. Who's on the phone? That's Gabriel.
Yes, Bishop, we don't have one congregational song together. Then I want to ask you to give us an open prayer to prepare us for the message. Okay, I want to pray the one more song, congregational song. Higher Ground, this is our song.
Lord, lift me up and let me stand. My faith on heaven's able land, a higher plane than I have found. Lord, plant my feet on higher ground.
Bishop Edward, I cannot hear you. Could you unmute? What?
Uh-oh.
Some technical difficulties. what's the second? Okay, I can start here. Okay, Bishop Edward, thank you very much.
I didn't have a microphone.
Oh, I see. Yeah, we saw.
I can you hear me?
Yes,
I can't hear you. I wonder why that is. But anyhow, I can pray.
Okay, please pray for us.
Heavenly Parent, today we're so thankful for your love that you have bestowed on all humanity. I just pray today, God, can we can learn how to return that love back to you as our Heavenly Parent, as we study your word, testify of who you are, and find out that we are a child of the King. So today, bless the speakers, our worship, our prayer, our scriptures, that we give you praise and honor in Jesus' name. Amen.
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 Amen. Good. So now, we're going to go to the message. We're going to call the Reverend Emily Gabriel. Please take a stage for us, Reverend Gabriel.
Praise the Lord. Once again, are you hearing me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Okay, praise the Lord. I want to welcome each and every one of us once again to this great time of refreshing in the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Bishop Edward, come around today. God bless you richly, sir, in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
Okay. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Like we have been told, we have been looking on the theme hunger for righteousness in the beginning of this year, right from first Sunday. And God has been revealing unto us, precept by precept, what righteousness is all about. We're made to understand that righteousness is doing things rightly, doing things rightly, doing things honestly. Praise the Lord. Maintaining integrity in all ramification. That is righteousness. And our God is the God of righteousness. He does things right. Hallelujah. And our text is taken from Matthew chapter 5 and verse 6. Matthew chapter 5 and verse 6. And the Bible says, blessed are you when you thirst and hunger for righteousness, for you shall be filled. Now, until you hunger and thirst for it, you cannot be filled. Hallelujah. You must be able to thirst and hunger for it. Then you can now be filled. Being born again is good, but it's not enough. The Bible speaking in Proverbs chapter 85 and verse 9, it says, surely his salvation is near them that fear him. His salvation is near them that fear him, that glory may dwell in our land. Now, for those who fear the Lord, his salvation is near them. And when we talk about salvation, we are talking about righteousness. We are talking about righteousness. Hallelujah. So, until when you thirst and hunger for it, you cannot be filled. So, you must move to the realm of thirsting and hungering for righteousness, so that as a child of God, as a minister of God, you can be what? You can be filled. And when we are filled with the righteousness of God, you discover that easily you'll be able to do that which is right. And if you are doing that which is not right before, you will see that easily you will drop them and move to the right, to the realm of doing that which is right. And that is why he told us in Matthew chapter 6 and verse 33, says, seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. So it tells you and me that righteousness is key in this Christian journey. Hallelujah. We cannot overstress, we cannot overemphasize the place of righteousness in our Christian life. No wonder the apostles, after Pentecost, all they were doing was right. All they were doing was according to pattern that they had been taught. So much so that when they got to the land that's called Antioch, the people there saw the kind of lifestyle they were living and said, of truth, this one that what? They are Christians. And that is Acts of Apostles chapter 11. They up to this one, they are what? They are Christians. Praise the Lord. Hunger for righteousness. Hunger for righteousness. The absence of righteousness is the what? Is the presence of sin. The absence of righteousness is the presence of sin. When righteousness is absent, sin comes in. Sin takes place. No wonder even Job, when he was going through challenges, hallelujah, he was able to come with boldness in Job 31 and verse 1. He said, I covenant my eyes that I may not sin. Hallelujah. I covenant my eyes. If you read the book of Job, Job chapter 31, praise the Lord. Job 31 is there, praise the Lord. He said, I covenant my eyes that I may not what? That I may not be seen. I made a covenant with my eyes that then should I think upon a maid. He made a covenant with his eyes. So you get to a point where you have to make a covenant with your eyes, with God. Say, God, I don't want to see sin, but I want to be seeing righteousness. I covenant my eyes to always see that which is right. I covenant my eyes to always that which is honest. I covenant my eyes to always that which carries integrity. And when you zero to that Bible, when you look at that word of God that we read now, that is Job chapter 31, when you go to verse 6, he said it there, I said that I may be weighed on a scale of integrity, honesty, righteousness. That I may be weighed on a scale of integrity. Job 31 and verse 6. Job was a man of God like me and you. So the absence of righteousness is the presence of sin, and sin will never be our portion in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. The absence of righteousness is what? Is the presence of fear. The absence of righteousness is the presence of fear. Where fear triumphs is because righteousness is absent there. Hallelujah. But when righteousness is present, boldness comes in. Hallelujah. Boldness does what? Boldness comes in. The presence of righteousness provokes boldness. I repeat, the presence of righteousness provokes boldness. While the absence of righteousness is the presence of what? Fear. So as a believer, as a leader, as ministers of God, we are expected to do what? To always hunger for righteousness. It's not one day prayer. It's every day and always, it's every day prayer that we have to pray. Quickly zero back with me to Proverbs chapter, that's in Proverbs chapter 85, and I'm reading from verse 10. And the word of God speaking to me and you expressly at this hour says, mercy and truth are met together. Righteousness and peace have kissed each other. Look at that. They work simultaneously. Righteousness, truth, peace. They are twin brothers. They are twin sisters. They walk hand in hand. Hallelujah. That is what the scripture is telling us. They walk hand in hand. Mercy and truth are met together. Righteousness and peace have kissed each other. Remember what I told you last week in Romans chapter 14 and verse 17. He said the kingdom of God is not only in meat and drink, but it's in righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. So you use scripture to interpret scriptures. Use scripture to interpret scriptures. Then when you zero again to verse 11, say truth shall spring out of the earth, and righteousness shall look down from the heaven. Righteousness is from heaven. Righteousness is from heaven. Our God is a God of righteousness. Our God is a God of holiness. So inhabit in the midst of righteousness. He habit in the midst of the congregation that does what? That carries and their thirst and hunger for righteousness. Verse 12, he said, yea, the Lord shall give that which is good, and our land shall yield an increase. See verse 13. Righteousness shall go before him and shall set us in the way of his steps. Righteousness will always set you on the right steps of life. Righteousness does not mislead. Righteousness points you to the right steps, right way, perfect way of God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hunger for righteousness. Hunger for righteousness. Quickly go with me to Proverbs 84. Proverbs 84 and verse 11. For the Lord God is a sun, hallelujah, and shield, that is protector. The Lord will give grace and glory. The Lord will give grace and glory. No good thing will he withhold from them that are upright. That is righteousness. Hallelujah. When you hunger and thirst for righteousness, and you can be able to get it, you know when you are doing it, you discover that the Bible says, nothing good shall be withheld from you. Nothing good shall be withheld from you for those who hunger and thirst for it. Praise the Lord. And I pray God through this teaching that me and you will thirst and hunger for righteousness, and God will listen to us. That was our heart desire in the name of Jesus Christ. Because as leaders, we are role models to our congregation and role models even to our children at home. Hallelujah. So that we begin to do that which is right always, all to the glory of God in Jesus' name. Quickly, I move to what I told us today, biblical personalities that does what? That hunger for righteousness. Biblical personalities that hunger for righteousness. Hallelujah. There are some personalities in the scripture that really hunger for righteousness, and then want to see those ones today. There are so many of them, hallelujah. There are so many of them, but I will just be picking 1, 2, and 3, and 4, 2 from the Old Testament, and then 2 from the New Testament. Like I said, there are so many of them. Number one on the list here is Papa Abraham. Abraham started his journey from Genesis chapter 12. If you read your scripture from Genesis chapter 12, where God called him out of his brethren, then Genesis chapter 1. And from Genesis chapter 2, he began to move from glory to glory based on the covenant that God established with him. And hence, all of us are alliance with Abraham. So we saw Papa Abraham was what? Was an epitome of righteousness. So much so in Genesis chapter 15 and verse 6. It was said, it was recorded for Papa Abraham that, and he believed in the Lord. He believed in the Lord. He believed in the Lord. All what God asked him to do, he did it holistically. And because he believed in the Lord and carried out that which was commanded for him to be done, the Bible said it was counted for him for what? For righteousness. It was counted for him for righteousness. So in other words, if me and you are doing that which is right, it will be counted for us for what? For righteousness. Seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. He's not telling us to go and seek other things. Other things will come in. Other things what? Will come in. Other blessings, God will release them unto us easily without any stress. Hallelujah. It was counted because he believed God. He believed God for his principles, for his prophecies, and for his promises. He hoped on God, and we saw what God did for him. Hallelujah. Hence, we are seeing it, and the Bible says it was counted to him for righteousness. Genesis 15 and verse 6. Hallelujah. Abraham lived a righteous life. He lived a successful life. And I pray God today, as many of us on this platform, we will live a life of success. And it will count for you and me for righteousness on the day of judgment in Jesus' name. who will live a spirit-filled life that will depopulate the kingdom of the enemy and populate the kingdom of God in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. I zero into Daniel. You see, Daniel got to the land of Babylon at the age of 18. And from day one, he made up his mind to hunger for righteousness and to live and dwell in righteousness. Hallelujah. We saw right from Daniel chapter 1 and verse 8. He said, Daniel proposed in his heart not to defile himself with the king's meat. That's the realm of righteousness. He proposed in his heart not to defile himself with the king's meat. Praise the Lord. He proposed in his heart not to do that which is unrighteous, but to do that which is righteous. And we saw the life of Daniel in the land of Babylon, right from Daniel chapter 1 through to Daniel chapter 12. How he displayed righteousness in the land of Babylon. And that which is good that is meant for him, what God released unto him. Hence, he triumphed in every area of life in the land of Babylon. And then that catapulted him to the highest level of governor in the land of Babylon. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. We saw it there. We saw it there. Even in the lion den, he was able to overcome. Because why? He is an embodiment of righteousness in the land of Babylon. You and me were an embodiment of righteousness here in America. That's the purpose why God brought us here for a time, and it's for a time like this. It's for a time like this that anywhere we find ourselves in a time like this, God give us the boldness to do what? To preach righteousness. To preach righteousness. Hallelujah. The topic still remains hunger for righteousness. And we are talking about biblical personalities that hunger for righteousness indeed. And that made them to excel both spiritually and physically. When we come to the New Testament, we saw Paul the apostles. Paul the apostle was a late comer in the roll call of the apostles. Hallelujah. We saw the exploit he did. Where from the time he became born again. And when he became born again, after having an encounter with our Lord Jesus Christ on his way to Damascus, things changed. He began to do things rightly. Before then, he was doing it wrongly. But after that encounter with our Lord Jesus Christ, he began to do things what? Rightly. And that counted for him for righteousness. And if you go and read his encounter from his visit, from the book of Romans, he wrote the epistles of Romans. And right from the other gospel, he moved to 1 Corinthians, 2 Corinthians, he moved to Ephesians, Galatians, hallelujah. We can see his exploits in the area of righteousness. And that kind was counted for him as affecting people's life, impacting people's life through that. And he succeeded both spiritually and physically. Praise the Lord. This was the Paul that came in. We saw it. If you read it and you will see it, then we all know about it. He stands out among the roll call of the apostles as one that distinguished himself in the area of righteousness. Praise the Lord. And then you see our Lord Jesus Christ. Our Lord Jesus Christ is a great embodiment of righteousness. Our Lord Jesus Christ stands out. Hallelujah. As the master of all, as the master of all, he came in flesh and he lived a life of righteousness. Hallelujah. All through, he lived what? A life of righteousness to show you and me that we cannot but live a life of righteousness also. There's nothing hard there. Praise the Lord. There's nothing to what? Hard there. So he's calling us, he's calling you and me to do what? To give all to God. To give all to who? To God. He did it. He did it. He came in flesh. He came in flesh. That we see in John chapter 1 and verse 12. John chapter 1 and verse 14. John chapter 1 verse 14. And the word was made flesh and dwelt among us. And we beheld his glory. And the glory as of the only begotten, of the Father, full of grace and truth. Full of grace and truth. That word truth there can also be translated to righteousness. Our Lord Jesus Christ came in flesh and he was full of righteousness. He displayed it. He practiced it. Hallelujah. He's our master. No other person you should see as your master. No wonder he spoke to us in Hebrews chapter 12, verse 2. Hallelujah. He said, looking unto Jesus Christ, the author and finisher of our faith. He did not say, look unto man. Look unto Jesus Christ and let your life be patterned after that of Jesus Christ. My life, your life must be patterned according to the life of Jesus Christ, who showed us the way of righteousness. He showed us the way of righteousness. Hallelujah. He was full of grace and truth. He was full of righteousness. When you look unto man, you miss it. But when you look unto God, hallelujah, you get it right. I pray this moment again that God in infinite mercy will see me and you through in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray, God, that which will hinder us not to hunger and thirst for righteousness, that God, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, will cut it away from us in the name of Jesus Christ. God will input, God will baptize each and one of us on this platform with the spirit of righteousness, that when he shall come, we shall all rapture with him. None of us be found wanting in the name of Jesus Christ. Whatever the spot or wrinkle in the life of anyone on this platform, I pray the blood of Jesus Christ that was shed on the cross of Calvary for remission of our sin will wash away every act of unrighteousness in our life this moment in the name of Jesus Christ. And righteousness will begin to take preeminence in my life, in your life, till eternity. So shall it be in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Then Gabriel, would you like to lead us for prayer?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Ask God for the grace to live a righteous life. Say, Lord, help me, O Lord. Give me the grace, O Lord, to live a righteous life. A life of righteousness, a life of integrity. Job prayed for it and God gave it to him. Why don't you ask God right now? Ask God. Say, God, give me the grace to live a life of righteousness. A life of impact, a life of emulation. Help me, God. Help me, God, to live a life of righteousness. In the name of Jesus Christ, talk to God. Talk to God. Talk to God. Talk to God. Say, God, help me, God. Help me, oh God. Help me, oh God. A life of righteousness. Help me, God, to live a life of righteousness. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ, talk to God, talk to God, talk to God, talk to God. Say, God, help me to understand your covenant. Help me, O God, to understand your covenant, O Lord. Help me, O God, to understand your covenant. You need an understanding of the covenant of God. Abraham understand it, and it was counted for him for righteousness. Talk to God this moment. God, give me understanding of your covenant, O Lord. Your covenant, O Lord, even and your commandments. Give me, O Lord. Give me, O Lord. Help me, O Lord. By your grace, O Lord, to understand your covenant and your commandments. In the name of Jesus Christ. Let's talk to God. Let's talk to God. Let's talk to God. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Talk to God. Talk to God. Ask God. Ask God for grace. Grace to understand his covenant and even his commandments. In the name of Jesus Christ. 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 Talk to God right now. Oh, talk to God. Say, oh Lord, according to Psalm 119, verse 133. And the Bible says, order my steps in thy word. Talk to God. Say, God, order my steps, oh Lord. By your word, oh Lord, order my steps in the right direction. Order my steps, oh Lord, in the right path of life. Oh Lord, in this journey of 2022, order my steps, O Lord, in the right part of life, in the name of Jesus Christ. Talk to God. Talk to God. Talk to God. talk to God in the name of Jesus Christ. Ask God right now, say, oh Lord, my Father, do not allow iniquity to dominate me. Do not, oh Lord, allow iniquity. Do not allow, oh Lord, sin. Do not allow, oh Lord, transgression to dominate me. In the name of Jesus Christ, talk to God. Talk to God. Oh Lord, my Father, do not allow sin. Do not allow iniquity to dominate me. In the name of Jesus Christ, talk to God. Talk to God. Talk to God. Talk to God. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Ask God for the grace to be more committed. Father and the Lord, grace to be more committed to your service this year, 2022. Give unto me. Grace to be more committed. Grace to worship you, Lord, in truth and in spirit. Give unto me, Lord. Give unto me, Lord. I need it now. I need that grace, O Lord. Grace, O Lord, to serve you in truth and in spirit. Grace to worship you in truth and in spirit. Father, listen to me now. Talk to God. Ask God. Ask God for that grace. Grace to be more committed to him, to his service in every ramification. Father, relate unto me, Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ. Relate unto us, O Lord, as many of us on this platform. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit, Lord. Soak yourself in the blood of Jesus Christ. Soak yourself in the blood of Jesus Christ. Soak yourself in the blood of Jesus Christ. Soak everything that has to do with you in the blood of Jesus Christ. Soak every member of your family in the blood of Jesus Christ. Every road you are passing through, everything that has to do with you, the air you are breathing in, the oxygen, everything, that blood of Jesus Christ. The elements in and around you, that blood of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit, Lord. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen. Yes. Amen. Thank you very much, Reverend Gabriel. I'd like to hear from Reverend Jesse Bishop Edward. Yesterday, actually, we had a wonderful prayer breakfast and with your wife Tanya presence, and I heard that you are speaking in another engagement. But it was a really amazing experience, that understanding that. This Martin Luther King Jr. is the righteous man in America. Reverend Gabriel gave us this biblical personality in those four fears. Of course, Jesus Christ, our Lord, is the number one. But in America, I think this Martin Luther King Jr. is a this righteous fear. And we had a memorial prayer breakfast, and Dr. Ruan Laos, chairman of the ACLC, spoke. And the one thing it really struck me was that he had a vision, he had a dream, and that he saw the promised land, but he already knew that he may not get there. You know, he was on the mountaintop and he predicted he may not get there, but he was really looking at the promised land. That's just like Jesus told us that we shall seek first the kingdom of God of his righteousness. So no matter what's happened in the horizon, the obstacles and even the death is kind of in the horizon, but he was looking at the God's kingdom, his righteousness. So I felt that, wow, it's really, he is the righteous man. So thank you very much that the opportunity we got yesterday. And Reverend Bishop Jesse Edward, would you like to give us some your takeaway and comment to our speech today?
Are you muted?
Bishop Edward. Bishop?
Mm-hmm.
Bishop Edward, can you hear us? Can you give us your comment?
I'm trying to talk. You hear me now?
Okay,
oh, yes,
yes.
Now we hear you.
I'm working on a different computer because my other one broke down, and this one doesn't have a mic, so I had to get an external mic, but I just now got to the point. I'm sorry, but Reverend Gabriel, boy, that was a good message. Appreciate the word. I guess we could talk for days and days on righteousness. There's so much, but I'm just thankful, as Brother David was talking about, Dr. King. Dr. King did not live long enough to become a part of ACLC. However, his son, Martin the Third, I think it is, whatever the number, there's so many of them. He did go to Korea with us, and I believe we went to Champion. It was there at Champion where we went to the top of the mountain and prayed. If Martin Luther King Jr. were alive, I believe he would have been there with us.
Amen.
At the top of that mountain, praising and worshiping, because they were all races, color, creed, and language. And I believe Dr. King was demonstrating the righteousness of God. It wasn't his righteousness, and it wasn't the minister. It was God showing his righteousness in his church. What does the scripture say? Brother Gabriel, we have no righteousness. There's none righteous, no, not one. But we can put on Jesus Christ, as you said, so fluidly. I appreciate that. We have to put on Jesus Christ. And Dave and Julie, I tell you, there's no better way to put on Christ than through the blessing, becoming his true child of God. So I appreciate that so much. Appreciate the word of God. Good job, Brother Gabriel. Keep up the good work.
Thank you. Thank you, just said that. Amen. Amen. Hi, Jenny, would you like to give us a comment?
Hey, yes. I just want to give honor to God who is the head of my life, and I want to greet every servant of God on the forum today in the wonderful name of Jesus. Reverend Gabriel has done a great job today again, as he always does. In the Word of God, righteousness in the Bible, righteousness mentioned 558 times. Oh, so we can see that actually that it's an extreme important matter, because if it's mentioned so much time, that means it's something that is very important. A little takeaway is righteousness is something that God wants from us. He wants that from us, righteousness. In Micah 6 and 8, it says, he has shown us, O man, what is good and what does the Lord require of you? But to do justly, to love mercy, and to walk humbly with our God. And in Proverbs 21 and 3, it says, to do righteousness and justice is more acceptable to the Lord than sacrifice. So sacrifice is not important than righteousness. When you is the word God says it, you know, not me. He says to do righteousness is and justice is more acceptable to the Lord.
Amen.
Than sacrifice. So you see that God wants us. He wants us to live righteous. He wants us to clothe ourselves at all times in his righteousness. And when we clothe in the righteousness of God, we'll able to feel free. We will able to walk freely. We will able to associate ourselves freely. We'll know how to talk to people freely. You know, we'll have that love, that compassion, that kindness, you know, the humbleness, that meekness, the gentleness. We will know how to serve as children of God. So righteousness is also something that we must practice. Isn't that something that you practice it, show it that, you know, that you're able, you know, you're a true believer of God, you're clothed in righteousness. In 1 John 2 and 29, it says, if you know that he is righteous, you know that everyone who practices righteousness is born of him. So you can identify a true believer of God because they practice righteousness, they clothe in righteousness. Their approach to you, you must see the righteousness of God shining in them. And it tells you that right there, you can see where the righteousness of God, you know, overflow on that person. In 2 Timothy 2 and the 22nd verse, it talks again about righteousness. It says, flee also youthful lusts, to pursue righteousness, faith, love, and peace with those you call on the Lord out of pure heart. So right there, when you close yourself in the righteousness of God, you have faith, you have love, you have peace, right? And in those, then you can call out to yourself that you say, I am a pure heart. God will see the heart. Like Pastor was talking about Daniel. In Daniel 10, you can see where when Daniel had a vision from the Lord, Daniel had an intimate relationship with God, and he was a man of righteousness because in his righteousness, you could see that he was a people person. Daniel looked out for the people of God because even though they were out of exile, everything was going on smooth, but he remembered the vision that God. Daniel was interceding on the behalf of the people of God. He went down in 21 days fasting, 3 weeks of fasting. He went down into that 21 days fasting. And right in the midst of that, there was the enemy that was there. His cry was, he was interceding that prayer to God. And even though the fallen angel once stopped, delay it a little, but yet still, because of the righteousness of Daniel, his prayer still moved because he had a connection with God. God was able to send Michael the archangel to set the messenger free so that the word couldn't go, his message could go. And right there, you see, have an encounter with God through the vision. That's righteousness. When you are righteousness, you must have an encounter with God. You have that relationship, that inner spirit, that inner man always saying, I see something that needed, see help. When you have the righteousness, when you talk about hunger, when a person hungry, they be hunting for something anywhere to find it to eat. And if we have that hunger, that means we have that really, really hunger for the things of God. Then we will find that we clothe ourselves in righteousness. Praise be his holy name. And these are my little takeaway. The next one I want to let is that righteousness is something that we can increase in by doing the things of God. Die daily in the word of God. Study the word of God. Help one another, look out for one another. Those are righteousness. That's the way you clothe yourself in righteousness. Matthew 5 and 6, and it says, blessed are those who hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. You will be filled. You want more and more and more and more. And the more consistent you constantly go in it is the more you want it. Right? Proverbs 4 and 18, it says, the path of the just is like shining sun that shineth ever bright into the perfect day. The day become perfect when you're clothed in righteousness. God bless you. That's my little takeaway today.
Oh, thank you very much. God bless you. Thank you for your words.
Praise be his holy name.
Okay, so next week, we have a very special occasion. I just want to make a quick announcement. Well, finally, the next Saturday, we have American Clergy Leadership Conference and Divine Power Ministry present the Blessed Marriage is the Cornerstone of God's Kingdom on Earth. Prayer and Fellowship on Saturday, January 29th is a Saturday, the 10 a.m. on Zoom. So everybody can participate, and we invited the Dr. Michael Jenkins. If you know him, you may be so surprised that we are able to bring him to this platform because he is really working so hard internationally. He is the international president of the Universal Peace Federation, which has a charter in 150 countries. It's also the ECOSOC status, was it? ECOSOC status of the in the United Nations NGO. So he was the chairman. Former chairman, emeritus, right, of the American Clergy Leadership Conference. So he has so much love to the clergies and Christian brothers and sisters, and he is so passionate about bringing the God's kingdom on the earth. So that's why he agreed to come and speak to us, and it's going to be next Saturday, and I'll send out the Zoom, and please invite your friend, invite your ministers and clergy, and I think everybody will love him and his words, his speech. So that's next week.
Also, Reverend Gabriel is presenting.
And also the Reverend Gabriel will give a word of greeting from the Divine Power Ministry, and also the from ACLC Westchester Rockland, and so, and also the Dr. Rouse will be present, and he agreed to come and this Saturday, and also the hoping that he will be a keynote speaker on the February 26th as well, and so we are really in the. Going to the national and international stage, and really the world is going to be delivered everywhere, and resurrect the people's heart and spirit, and raising up the more righteous people, and as we are talking today. So this is our announcement. So let's stop sharing. Thank you very much. Jenny, would you like to give a closing prayer for us?
Father, we thank you for this wonderful privilege that we can come again, Lord Jesus, another Sunday, Lord, in this room, oh God, as a body of Christ. Oh God, to honor your word, Lord, to honor you, Lord Jesus, to lift you up, to glorify you, Lord. We thank you for today. We thank you for the word that, oh God, was given unto us today, Lord God. We pray in the name of Jesus that these words, Lord God, may live inside of us, Lord God. We pray, God, that you stamp your righteousness deep down in each and every one of us' heart today, Lord. That as we walk our daily lives, oh God, we may able, Lord Jesus, oh God, to not only to keep it to ourselves, but to act it, to practice it. To live it, Holy God, to share it, Lord God, to each and every one that we come in contact with. We pray you bless your servant, anoint him afresh again, Lord, that each day is called upon to give your word, Lord. Lord Jesus, it may fill up, Lord God, with your anointing, with your power, Lord God, with your word, Lord Jesus, oh God, that others may, oh God, be jealous and get, Lord Jesus, oh God, to know you more. By just getting into the word, Lord. Hallelujah. We pray, God, that you bless each and every one of us that are here today. Bless our family, those who are not on the forum today, Lord. We pray, God, that your blessing may share amongst them in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord, and we give you praise. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
And surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us.
Shall follow us.
All the days of our life. And we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you very much, everybody.
Thank you.
A wonderful session. And see you. So